When I was in high school, during my first year of going to the GSA club, I got picked on one day after school from some kids on the bus. I didn't know who they were. And they decided to say, oh, I should go date this person because I obviously have to be a lesbian in order to go to a GSA club. And I just, at the time, I didn't know if I really liked the girls at the time, and it was just kind of really hard to take that and be assumed. And like, I never really told anybody, and I was kind of this kid that not only did I suffer from ADHD with autistic characteristics, but I was trying to figure out who I was. And it even hurt more because I couldn't really trust my teammates, and I was even afraid to go up to my coaches.
I wanted to take a girl to senior prom with me, and when word got around to the administration, the guidance counselor called me in and told me that would not be allowed, and that I wouldn't be allowed to come to senior prom at all with a girl or with a guy. The fear was that, you know, once I was told that I couldn't do this, that I might act out in some way.
I know that at least openly, people weren't very aggressive. I was fortunate enough to come from a very liberal area, but I remember I would do the day of silence, and that is where you are, you take an oath of silence to kind of reflect people of the victims of bullying who can't speak up for themselves, things like that. I think it was only on that day that people actually feel comfortable coming up to me and bullying me or saying, like, you know, faggot or whatever. Mm-hmm. And it was the only day people actually thought that was, you know, like, an okay thing to do. Which is kind of messed up, but I think on the other half of that, there are some people who saw their openly homophobic behavior and they're like, wow, that person sucks, I don't really want to talk to them anymore. So it's mixed results, I guess. There was one time when I came out first at what I thought was bisexual. I had a best friend of mine that I had been friends with for like 5 years or so, and I told her that I was bisexual, and she stopped talking to me for about the rest of high school.
Here at Kirkwood, I've almost been pushed down the stairs because I was walking with a guy that I was dating at the time.
I think it would have been different if our school actually reinforced and had more of a safety zone area, because most kids, like, teachers won't even reinforce it. At my high school, it wasn't even reinforced that much. Maybe a little bit from time to time if the teachers had taken the training or cared about it, but some of my teachers didn't at my high school because they felt one thing was more important than, you know, like calling it out and letting students know that this is not okay, this is not right.
I think it would have been more empowering for myself as a person. When I was in high school, and at my high school, I was the only person that was out. Mm-hmm. And so I was kind of both the target, but I was also kind of the token, because like everybody that I went through school with, they were all my friends, you know. And sometimes there would be something about, you know, the idea that I was gay, and they would go, yeah, Shelly's a problem that way. Or they would say, that's just Shelly. You know, she's just one of us. I was always prepared for being not attacked, but
some sort of backlash.
Yeah.
It really would have helped if teachers actually stepped in, because some of the discriminatory, like name calling, things like that, did happen in front of teachers. I think a few times the teacher did pull a student aside and said, hey, you can't really say that in my classroom. But it would have been a lot nicer if they would have stood up, because it wasn't just me. I often saw other people who would get bullied and teased or whatever, and teachers didn't. Some of them said some things, but not everyone said enough. So I think if it was a more cohesive, forward effort, people would be much more, or feel safer anyway.
so tired of your boat, down deep in a hole, can't do it alone.
Probably would have been happier.
Yes.
Probably would have completed high school with better grades, and probably wouldn't have been worrying about being pushed downstairs during my first two semesters here.
I would say that the sooner you try to seek the help and try to find a place where you belong, that you try to do is get through it as best as you can, not just stand there and let it happen. Like, if your teachers won't help, go to the principal, go to the superintendent, go to people that will help and have the ability to do something about it.
Don't give up. If you end up getting insulted or assaulted, well, I'd say go to the police, because the school system doesn't seem to want to do anything, really.
Is that your experience then? Did you go to the school and something happened and they didn't do anything?
Yeah.
If you don't have a GSA, try to find someone who can help you start one. I think in almost every high school, everywhere, there's at least one teacher, one counselor, something, or a janitor even, who is okay with gay. And just like try and find a support system. Go online and find these support systems. Like, you are definitely not alone. There are gay kids everywhere. Statistically, 1 in every 10 people is gay in some fashion or another. So they're everywhere. They just might not be as open about it. And I think that if you're brave enough and to be open about yourself and be open, like, hey, I'm gay, hey, I'm pan, I'm ace, I'm polyamorous, because I know that there are quite a few people here who, because I'm very open about my sexuality and my romantic whatever, I've actually helped some people realize, like, oh, I am polyamorous because I talk about it so damn much. And if I think the people who are so open about their sexuality are really, like, are so important to this movement.
Find an adult ally. Talk to your parents. Talk to older people who have gone through difficult things before. Surround yourself with positive people. Because you really have to take care of yourself. You have to have a good, positive sense of self that's not based on a defensive position or a fallacy about some fantasy, right? Be real and be true to yourself, because that's what's going to help you weather the storms of life, if you will, right? If you're having trouble, talk to somebody. Don't stuff it. That doesn't do any good. If you're having trouble, don't ignore it. You know, talk to somebody. Find a solution to the problems in your life.